Hi Nick, I wanted to talk a bit about where I am with Racer and about the prospect of Rusty supporting tools and IDEs. I wanted to demo a couple of things, and so rather than get you to set up some software, I thought I'd try a video to do that. So I don't know how much you've used or seen Racer, so I'll start with that. So let's start a new file. So Racer already provides a certain amount of completion and navigation without using Rust C's inference. So if I import a module here, you see it's giving me suggestions. And here we go, hash map. And so I'm importing a hash map here, and then when I can use it in the code, it knows that it's imported now, so it completes it here and it offers me functions. And also, it can do so far, it's only really been following paths, but it can also do a bit of type inference. So it knows the type of H, or it kind of knows the type of H, because it can navigate through to the new function and know that new returns a hash map. And so here it's offering me the methods on the hash map by looking in the import and basically pulling them out using the text. So if we insert an element into our hash map here, then you can see that we can navigate through to the insert method. And so really, Racer's Achilles heel comes when it encounters some type inference that it can't do. So in this case, let's do this. So we'll pull the element out of the hash map, and then we want to see what methods are on A, and we can't here. It says no completion found, and the reason is that Racer isn't able to follow this through and realize that the type parameter V here is actually a string, because the string is the second parameter in the thing. And it also actually doesn't know how to do indexing, which isn't that difficult to add, I guess. But basically, I think Racer needs help from Rust C, and so that's where we are. So to help me think about how Rust could provide this functionality, I've written a little prototype. So let me dig that up now. Then I'll talk about it a bit. Okay, so what this basically does is that I'm getting Emacs to pass it the file name and some coordinates. And then this function is basically, actually, it does a little bit of cargoing just in case it's a cargo crate. But if we ignore that, basically it's firing up the compiler and getting the compiler to take the crate code all the way through to type inference. And once it has a type inference context down here, then I just run a visitor on it. And when it can match the expression to the coordinates that the editor sent it, then it ends up printing the type. So I think we call, yeah, here we are. Type context expression ty adjusted gives us the type, and then this basically just prints it out at the end here. So we go back to our file. There's a couple of problems with this approach as it stands, but the most obvious thing is that Rust C can only take crates that compile. So we need to change this code to something that will compile. So actually, yeah. So if I do this, then this obviously won't compile, but we can make a small pre-processing step and get that to compile. Actually, oh, I've missed out a mute there as well. Okay, so this should compile now. Yep, great. So in that case, our tool should be able to print us out the type of this function. Okay, here we go. So I'll press the button and there we go. We can see it's a reference to a string. And now this compiles, this should work for any expression in the thing. That's a string, inserts returning us an option of a string. 35 is an int 32. You get the general idea. Like this fact, yep, that's a function. This is returns a type of hash map, and it can resolve the rest of the type parameters, obviously, because it has the whole crate. So it knows that the first type parameter is an I32, and the second one is a reference to a string. So the hurdles, I mean, so this is great. If Rust could use this out of the box, then it could provide this completion easily, because it knows the type and it's just a case of looking for the string methods, which is, it's pretty good at, and it can be like it, there's no good reason why it can't just be perfect at that. So what are the other hurdles? Well, I mean, we've seen that we need to get code compiling in Rust C. And you pointed out in the RFC that that either we could do some kind of pre-process step, which I think is, either we can do some sort of pre-process step, or we can maybe modify Rust C to be able to take code that it isn't well formed and still get it to the type analysis stage. The other real hurdle is getting everything fast enough so that Rust can use it in real time. And you can't really see it from this, but if we have another crate in mind, so let me load up the Rust source. The type checking crate's a good one. So let's pick an expression in here. Anything will do, really. Let's see what v.clone is here. It's thinking about it. There we go. So it's an option of type, a vector of Elysian failure infos. But you could see that it took quite a while to come back with that. So we also need to be able to have the compiler get the type analysis information fast enough for Racer to be able to use it. So that's basically where I am. I've got a few ideas for how to get this faster. I wrote a blog post, it's probably a few months ago now, where I thought I can possibly, with the compiler as it was then, give it a cut down version of the crate to take to the type inference stage by basically removing all of the method bodies and all the function bodies, and also maybe stripping out code that's unreachable from the particular function that I'm interested in, and that can possibly get us like most of the way there. There's a few other issues that need to be overcome. One of them actually is, so we can see that Racer can provide us with methods completions here, but if we try and compile that, Rust C isn't able to get us to a full compile because it doesn't have enough type information to infer the full type of H. It might actually be possible to pull out partial types from Rust C's side tables, I don't know. Okay, so I just wanted to say that I mentioned this in the email. I'm less interested in specifying the Oracle sort of high level stuff, mainly because I see Racer and other tools and IDEs providing this role without the need for like a centralized RFC and like a process for getting those sort of things. But the type inference and lifetime inference really requires tight integration with Rust C, and I think that's really where we should be spending our efforts, at least in the short term. Okay, I hope that made sense, and I'll email you soon. Okay, cheers.